As to a centre for instructions, referee Brad Conway.
Excited for this fight, Dave. I was speaking to Mo earlier on in the afternoon.
Was that right? Did he have a message for his opponent?
He did indeed, yeah, he did. He said, James, I want you to let my guy know. Beat me if you can. Survive if I let you. So, Mo's definitely meaning business today.
18 years old, Tony's 27. Touch of gloves to start off. Nice leg kick from over.
Straight away, he checks the leg kick.
Spawning by Tony.
Lots of point here for Mo as well.
He's getting it from over. Tony's looking for a clinch. Mo's got double end hook, so he's looking for a takedown.
Mo gets a takedown. Great work. Oh, the referee takes a tumble in there.
What happened there?
Brad got knocked down by Mo. Mo's takedown's obviously that heavy and that powerful. He took the referee down as well as his opponent.
Tony's working from his guard now. He's got an elevator on the right hand side. Mo's got quite a good base, so I don't think he's going to get reversed so easy.
He's staying really tight. He's putting a rubber guard.
Rubber guard. Good exactly.
He's going to allow him to pass. Mo's hanging on to that single. He's driving hard.
Great flexibility from Tony there.
Fantastic. And even in his single leg defence there, he was trying to stand with that leg across. He's showed some great flexibility, as you say there, Dave.
Tony's a debut fighter. He said he's got an MMA background, but he's obviously been training some Eddie Bravo rubber guard stuff. Don't like that myself.
You're not a fan, Dave?
I'm not at all, no.
Having trained with you, Dave, I can attest to that.
Tony's working for guillotine now.
It looks tight. Mo's trying to push her out of there. He's trying to dig in. Great work there from Mo. Manages to get out of the guillotine.
Tony's got a very good offensive guard here, though. He's making Mo work quite hard from the top.
It's good. He's not one of these guys who are happy to just lay and pray.
Amateur rules, you really got to, haven't you? I mean, you can't just sort of lie on your back and you're going to be losing points in your judges' scorecards the longer you do that. You've got to stay active in your back. He's trying to wall walk off a cage now as well, I think.
For a debut fighter, Tony's showing a really good awareness of where he's in the cage and a great level of skill.
He is. He needs to get back into guard, though. I mean, Mo's still got him inside control. Tony hasn't really got any use of his hips here, though, so he needs to be getting back into guard if he's going to have any kind of offensive attacks from here.
He's going to look to try and sweep.
He's got a nice underhook there, though.
Yeah. In his stature, and now get those hips back in and try and reclaim that guard. Mo moves to that crucifix position.
I'd be looking for an arm triangle from there.
You'd be looking to pound me in the face, Dave, I know. I think that's where Mo's picked up the crucifix from, definitely training with you.
If he shoots to slide his left arm underneath there, he'd be able to look for an arm triangle choke on the far side. But
showing some patience there.
Tony still needs to be looking for something here. It's a nice, he's many near burst out there, but
it's really nice work.
Mo's managed to keep that position quite well. It's a good base somewhere. I know it's quite hard to shift from top position.
He is, yeah. He's a shorter guy. Finding training that he's hard to move in general, and his top game's pretty good.
Mo's keeping his hips controlled well. That's the main, I think, for Tony at the moment, that's what's going to get him out of his position, is just moving his hips, shrimping out and getting his hips back into guard. He's also got a good offensive guard, so the fight's going to be won for him if he stays there.
If Mo can just secure that arm, I mean, time's probably going to run out on his ear, but he could look to work that head and arm choke. It's a shame that come to the end of this round, because it is definitely there waiting for it.
That's the end of the first round. How did you score that one, James?
To be honest, me personally, I'm always a fan of the guy. Even when he's on his back, he's showing his guard up and he's working for submissions. I think Tony did really well there.
Definitely a close round there. I mean, Mo had takedowns, Mo had control from top the whole time. But
yeah.
Tony had a couple of good submission attempts there. He worked, I think he had Mo in a bit of trouble with that that Gogo Plata attempt.
Yeah, I mean, if he would have been able to secure him down a little more, because obviously as he's moved it up, Mo was able to posture, a little more control, and he may well have had it.
Mo did look uncomfortable for a second there, though.
He did indeed,
Yeah, he was working for guillotine later on as well. I don't think that was... That never had Mo in too much trouble. He did have to work to get out of it again. Mo was looking for that arm triangle choke towards the end of the first round.
Different styles, really. Although it's been mainly contested on the ground, the difference in style shows, like you say, you've got the flexibility and the offensive guard of Tony, and then obviously Mo's trying to keep that tight top game and working inches, really, to get that.
Judge at the cage side, of course, we scored in the fight based on effective striking, effective grappling, control of the octagon. Got to give the control there to Mo.
Yeah, I would agree with you on that one.
I would edge him towards effective grappling then for the takedowns and the ground control, the top positions. But definitely not a dominating round by any stretch.
No. Very evenly matched fighters here today. Great to see that.
Tony making his debut, of course. I've got quite a few nerves out of the way in that first round. See how the second one pans out. I think Mo will be looking for a takedown again quite soon.
I would agree, although it seems like it's...
Tony getting against the cage. Mo could be using the case for his advantage. He's pressing him down. He's going off legs. That's a take that I'm quite a fan of myself.
Nice sweep almost there. Great work from Tony. Manages to get back to his base.
Mo needs to be getting onto his feet, get off his knees from there and drive through. You know, power from your knees, so he needs to be getting back on his feet and driving through. Tony's looking for back and now it's Mo in his guard.
Great work, Mo.
Let's see what Mo can do from his guard.
Great work there to get back to guard. Like you say earlier on, we've seen a guy who was happy to just sort of stay on his back. With a guy on his back, sorry. Mo instantly recognising the problem there and rolling to his back, getting his guard back. And now Mo also showing some flexibility in the hips. He's throwing at the rubber guard into mission control position.
Is that what that's called? You know, I'm not a fan of rubber guard at all.
You just like to mount guys and punch them, Dave.
Yeah, basically, yeah. I don't know if Eddie Bravo would approve, but...
Not if he was getting hit. I'm sure he wouldn't. No. I don't approve when you hit me, but anyway, that's by the by.
Now, Mo needs to be looking for either a sweep or a submission in my book here.
I agree, Dave. Definitely. You don't run your back for too long. The judges are going to favour the guy who's on top, regardless of... Oh, nice, nice sweep. Beautiful work from Mo.
Tony was going for the knee over baseball slide pass, but I think his base was a little bit too far back and centre of gravity was such a Mo could reverse him.
Definitely. And that hit, again, Mo finds himself in this position that we found himself towards the back end of the first round.
He's going to try and keep some pressure on the right leg of Tony then. Pass over towards his left.
Needs to keep that head out of the way because Tony will latch onto that guillotine again. Manages to clamp on half guard.
He's quite good at there, but of course Tony will need to have guarding if he's going to try and get a choke on Mover. Mover's obviously a strong guy, he's not going to get choked out easily.
He's stubborn as well as Mo. He's one of those stubborn guys that, you know, like you say, you're not going to get it easy.
And that's his secured side control position.
Arms hanging out there, hopefully Mo can recognise that.
Still got plenty of time left in the round to work. He's controlling the wrist.
Nice defence there, bringing the knee into... stop more from trapping it.
Nearly had an arm triangle again there.
Yeah. I think Tony needs to be wary of that, and his corner should be letting him know because it is something he's putting out there. Oh, nice step over from Mo. Looking for the armbar. Tony gets out of there. Great work from Tony.
Didn't quite set that up right. Put a little bit over eager by Mo there. It's a nice scramble going on here now. Mo's got his guard back for him. That's going to make it very difficult for Tony to go for a choke or anything. Last 10 seconds of this round. Very evenly matched round, this one.
To be honest, I think it's a very well matched fight. It's been exciting from the start.
And that's the end of round two. Tony Dawson showed some very good skills for debut fighting.
Definitely. I know it's cliche, but I have to say, I wouldn't want to be scoring this. I'm glad we can enjoy it.
Absolutely.
It's a very close fight. Somewhat of a slobber knocker, Dave.
That's a word I would probably use myself.
Yeah, definitely the first slobber knocker of the day.
How do you think the fighters are looking at the end of the second round now? Mo's still stood up. He's looking, he's breathing, but he's looked pretty calm. He's listening to some stuff.
He looks really calm.
There.
Yeah, good point that. To be honest, I'm not a fan of sitting down in between rounds. You know, even if it's just a mental thing, if my guy who I'm looking across the cage at is standing when I'm tired and I need that seat and he's still standing ready to go, you know, it's definitely demoralising. So I always try and stand up in between rounds. That's just me, though.
I think you can read a lot into it, though. If a fighter sat down at the end of the first round, he still sat down at the end of the fifth round, then it really is any difference. Whereas if a fighter's stood up at the end of the first round...
And he's sitting.
And he's sitting by the third.
Tells a lot.
Absolutely. Tony doesn't seem to be breathing too hard, though, anyway.
Both guys have prepared well for this. You can definitely tell that. Both have come in good shape.
I reckon we're still going to get a good third round out of these guys.
Definitely.
I'd like to see a finish, though.
Yeah, that'd be a great way to finish the fight.
Both fighters have worked well, but... It'll be a shame to see this one go to the judges.
Yeah.
It's a very slow leg kick from Tony.
Beautiful leg kick there from Mo.
Fighters right up against the announcing position here.
Hearing everything going in there.
Mo's going to be looking for a takedown again. They have a low knee there.
Yeah, he needs to watch those. He's working the inside thigh though. I think that's possibly why it went the first time into a legal knee.
Both double unducks by Mover. He's going to be looking around to take her takedown from the back.
Trying to work
pop
the
his
back
head
now.
Out. He should be able to take his back from there. Oh, that was a huge takedown by Mo.
Beautiful takedown. I dare say you'd have been proud of that yourself, Dave. From the Hollywood handbook itself.
He's working for straight arm there. Again, Tony's able to use his knee to break that. It was a dangerous position, though.
Yeah. Tony's showing fantastic awareness in there, I have to say. Really, he's showing great ability to defend and attack.
That's an excellent start to round from Mogo. Definitely stamping his authority on this fight. And that's going to leave an impression in the judges' minds when it comes to the scorecards.
Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, I think if the third round continues in this way, the first and the second will find more competitive. It does put a stamp
on. By Mo now.
Beautiful work there.
And for Mia, he must be looking for... It looks like he's looking towards a mountain triangle here.
Yeah, he's working that S-mount there position, and he seems really comfortable there.
Mm. Got the arm there. When he's switching over, he wants to be locking that arm up and then working towards the armbar.
Staying tight.
Takes his time over it there. You want to rush his position, especially with Tony. Tony knowing as much as he does on the ground, you don't want to rush it.
Exactly. The only problem with him now is he's up against that cage. So he's not
the arm, yeah. Just keep his head controlled. He should be able to... But it's going to be difficult for him to extend the armbar because he's got his back against the cage.
If anything, he should attack the far arm and maybe bring that in, and it would limit how much he can defend.
I mean, if Mo was right in front of me now, I would be saying to him, work on the grip. Stay in that position and work on the grip, because that's what's preventing the arm from extending.
He definitely doesn't want to jeopardise his position because he's worked so hard to get it, and here we end up in a funky sort of inverted guard from Tony.
Yeah, I don't know what this position is. Tony's out of danger for the time being, at least.
Some kind of pinning combination, you might say. He wants to be careful with the inverted triangle there. There's more.
He's got his elbow out there.
Beautiful position.
There you go. That's a good reversal by Tony there. Managed to get himself out of danger, but back into side control again. And Mo's clearly got enough energy to keep pressing the attack. And I think he's looking for finishing. He doesn't want it to go to scorecards.
Yeah, you never want to leave it to the judges. You don't know what they're looking for, and you can't always say what they've seen. Even if you feel you've dominated, sometimes judges won't see it your way.
No, sometimes judges won't see it at all.
Yeah, sometimes they're not paying attention. not these judges though. We must say they look like they're really well tuned into what's
going
on.
Very well qualified and respected judges working this way. So that's 10 seconds of a fight now.
Very dominating.
Still time to finish, but I don't think Tony's going to let him have it from here. Mo's, he's already fought once, he's got a bit of experience, and I think it might have showed in that fight.
Definitely did. I would agree with you there.
Very close fight up until third round, but I would say based on third
round.
And there we go, takes a unanimous decision, as you and I said.
Yeah, even before it started. No, a fantastic fight, like I say. That was definitely so far my pick for fight of the day. Skills.
I think it's a takedown that won it for him.
Yeah. A slam will do that.
I'll certainly be congratulating him on that later.
Congratulating or taking more credit?
The two of us won the same amount.
Yeah.
Shouting it.